Hey guys, this is the fourth video in the 5 video series in which I have explained how to install SSD in the HP and V laptop and then configure Windows in a way that the Windows boots and operates on SSD. All you need to do is turn off your computer and then take out the hard disk and then put back the hard disk and then put back the cover and then put back the battery then insert the USB which contains the Windows operating system setup and then boot the computer. The laptop will boot again to the Windows installation wizard, then select the appropriate settings, go next. Accept the terms and conditions, then custom installation. Now you can see that we already have 4 partitions on the SSD on which we have installed Windows. Now we need to install Windows again, this time on the hard disk. You can see the disk 0 is the 1 TB of hard disk. We are going to install Windows on this now. Just select the disk 0. If you are confused about the drives, you can see the size of them to get an idea which is the hard disk and which is the SSD. Select disk 0 which is the hard disk and then click next. The Windows will install on the hard disk. I'm just going to fast forward this part. Then after rebooting, Windows will just finish installation and eventually we will reach desktop. Now we need to configure the Windows in a way that it boots from SSD. Go to start menu and then settings. Go to this update and security. You can see there is a button for recovery. Then go to restart now under advanced startup. Now you can see this option, use another operating system. Select this. Now you can see we have 2 windows installed on volume 2 and volume 6. Click on choose change defaults, then click on choose a default operating system. Now this will show the Windows 10 is installed on volume 6 and volume 2, but on mine this is volume 2 and volume 6. Volume 6 is I think the SSD and volume 2 is on the hard disk, so I need to select volume 6. If you are not sure which volume is on your hard disk and which is on your SSD, you can refer disk management before shutting down the computer. Select volume 6. The Windows will boot in the SSD now. Give the password and Windows is working on the SSD. If you want to see, let me show you. By but the Windows is running on drive C this time, so we can go ahead and just delete the or format the drive D, because we are not going to need the Windows installation files there, and we are going to boot our computer using the SSD. So you can just go ahead and format this, and if you want to see that it's everything is still fine, you can restart your computer. Press restart. And within few seconds your computer will restart, because installing Windows on SSD makes a lot of difference. Let me just start this. Now we need to get rid of that screen where we can choose which Windows to boot from. Let's press Windows key, then type msconfig, then move to the boot tab and then select the entry, the upper entry, the Windows installed on D drive, and then delete it. So we have deleted the entry for the Windows which was installed on the D drive. Then restart the computer again. Yeah, you can see that we did not see that menu where we need to choose which operating system to boot from, and Windows directly booted through the SSD this time. So this completes our entire process. If you want, you can see the details here. Windows is installed on SSD and the D drive, that is the hard disk, is completely empty. You can open disk management to see more details. You can open disk management and you can see that disk 0, that is the hard disk, has the D drive, and the disk 1, that is the SSD, has the C drive which contains our operating system. So this completes the entire setup. In the next video I'm going to compare the performance between the hard disk and the SSD. See you there. Thanks for watching.